I think people's eyes are going to pop out of their head, to be honest. Just the people that I've shown on the bank, they're like, hang on a minute, you know, something special here. And that's what I thought as soon as I picked it up. You know, I knew we had something, and I think people will think exactly the same.
So here today at the beautiful Docklow Pools in Herefordshire with Des Shipp, and we're going to be looking at some of the special features of the brand new Response M90 pole. Now, this is something you've helped us develop over the past 12 months, and I really do think we've got a really special product here.
Yeah, I mean, I've been using this now for about 6 or 7 months, the prototype one, which I've actually got down here, and it's been absolutely wonderful to fish with, Scott, to be honest. You know, I've had some massive weights of Carpan F1s, silverfish and everything, and it's on a different planet, basically.
Yeah, I think the biggest single thing we outlined at the start was to get a pole that was a true all-rounder.
Yeah.
That you can fish for silverfish on your lakes, your canals, your rivers.
Yeah.
But something that's capable of catching 300-400 pound of carp on a commercial. One pole to do everything. I think that was the remit.
Yeah, that's right. That's what I've wanted, and that's what we've come up with. And it's an absolute fantastic piece of kit. And it's the only pole I want in me old all, to be honest.
Yeah, I think so. I think what's special about this is we're using 100% pure, high-performance Japanese carbon fibre from Torayca.
Yeah.
And I think this material development has really helped us to achieve
exactly what we want. Yeah, exactly what we want. You know, we've asked basically what we want, and they've come up with the goods. And, you know, they've actually done a fantastic job. And I can't really say much else about it, really. It's just what I've wanted since I've been fishing.
So there you have it. Des Shipp. Happy, not something you see every day. So let's have a look at some of the features that's put that smile on his face. So Des, we talked about the carbon.
Yeah.
This is the number three section from the pole.
Yeah, we've actually got no number ones. So the number one now is gone. So when you elasticate your pole, you haven't got that little bit in the end, that's gone. So we've actually made the top threes the same length as what they would if you actually had the number one in, for obvious reasons. I think the right length, the right bore sizes for the elastics, and obviously I've been out sort of fishing with them, and to be fair, they're absolutely bang on. But as you can see on that, that's the third section.
The number three, which your top kits go straight onto.
Yeah, reinforced, obviously stopping your wear and tear, and I've been using it for the last 6 months, and it's been absolutely brilliant. I've just put the pole apart, no carbon on your hands or anything.
Yeah,
so
I mean,
that's doing its job.
Particularly commercial fishing, when you're using just top kits, a little bit different if you're fishing natural venues. So basically that's a 1k carbon weave, which just gives you extra reinforcement, as Des says, stops it wearing or prevents it wearing as quick, so you know your pole will last you longer, give you more confidence to fish, not going to get paper thin where you keep unshipping, particularly if you're catching as many fish as Des. In addition to the reinforcement, which you've got all the way through your pole and every section, you've got this new anti-friction finish. It's always been a problem, particularly like today when it's sunny at stages, then it's raining with the pole sticking through your hands, Des.
It's been absolutely brilliant. Like you said, even when the pole is damp, it's still really, really easy to use. And it feels quite rough to the touch, but believe me, when you're fishing with it, it flows through your hands really, really good.
Yeah, I think that's the benefit of it. It still flows through the hands when it's dry, but that sort of textured finish.
Texture definitely helps you shipping it out really quickly.
Yeah, particularly when it's wet as well, gives you that little bit of grip.
Yeah.
So we've talked about the carbon and the reinforcement on the sections. Reinforcement is one of the key things we've tried to put into the pole. Get a lot of stress these days, don't they, catching big weights of
commercial striking.
Fish.
Striking's one of the biggest things. And once again, on all the big sections, your 13, 14 half and 16, we've got a reinforcement. You could probably see that little rim there. From there to there is obviously where you're going to hold it on your elbow. So for striking, you're not going to have any problems with putting your elbow through the part, you know, through the carbon. So that's really, really important. And it's on the big sections, which obviously most of the time is where you're striking really hard.
Yeah, just it's under a lot of stress, yeah, in it when you strike at a long distance. You've got about 30 centimetres there. And
yeah, another really nice thing is what we've done as well. We've got three mini butt sections. This actually fits your 8.5, your 10 metre, your 11.5, 13, 14.5 and 16. So wherever you are, if you're on a canal and you want to fish that little, you know, on a shelf and you've not quite got it, we've come up with three little mini sections which fit basically quite a lot of the pole, to be honest.
Basically, the six sections at the end of the pole, as Des says, this one is your 14 and your 16, both fit onto this because the sections are parallel. These two are actually reversible, fitting two sections each, and these all come as standard as part of the package.
Yeah, really, really good, and mega, mega strong as well. So like I said, if you are fishing short at 10 metres and you're striking, you can put one of these on and they're mega, mega strong. You're not going to break anything at all.
Yeah, we touched on top kits earlier.
Yeah.
We worked a lot, didn't we, on the optimum length.
Yeah, lengths, you know, what I want and obviously I think what most people want. We don't want too much elastic because when you're catching lots of F1s in carp, you don't want too much elastic because they just run you all over the lake.
Yeah.
So we've come up with an optional sort of length we thought was better, you know, the best for both really, best for silverfish and carp. So we got the power kits there, really, really good quality, very light for what, you know, mega strong but very light. All pre-bushed, so when you actually buy the pole, the bushes are already fit. Everything exactly the same length. The kit for your silverfish and for your carp are identical, so you don't have to do anything. You just basically elasticate it when you get it, and it's job done. And this, the carp ones will probably take elastics up to 16.
Yeah, 16.
16 hollow.
Comes with a blue slip, a blue, internal bush, yeah, ready
blue slip, already to go.
And if you can just show us a match kit, Des.
Yep. There's the match kit. Got no elastic through that today at the moment. That's a orange internal, so that'll take up to an 8 slip elastic, you know, or light hollow. Like I said, exactly the same length.
Yeah, they're actually 2.4 metres in length, which after a lot of deliberation, we concluded that that's the optimum length for most styles of fishing.
Yeah.
And with your spot-on cupping kit, again, that's included in the package, you can just pull it out to the exact same length, and every kit you've got is exactly the same length, ready to fish. With the occlusion of your 16 metre half butt, the pole is a true 16 metres. Yeah. So there's no cutting back, so you're fishing shorter. What you see is what you get. It's a 16 metre true pole and you're ready to fish.
Yeah, and just one thing, Scott, as well, all the power kits come with the rotor puller bung already in it.
Ready fitted, little bit of reinforcement.
Reinforcement, right, you don't have to do anything. Like I said, just elasticate it and you're ready to go. Simple as that.
Absolutely brilliant. Again there, Des, slightest indication.
Tiny indication, and you know, like I've said in all my features I do, you know, little dinks, little bites, and this is made, it's going to make it a lot easier to hook the fish.
And just eat them tiny indications.
Just the easiness. It's sort of like I've got to actually go back. I've got to think about how hard I'm going to strike now.
Yeah.
Because it is so quick, you don't have to give it the big whoosh, you know.
Particularly, you know, F1s as well, it can be particularly shy biting. And
very frustrating fishing as it is, and you know, with this, I mean, I've had it. Like I said, I've had it. I've used them. I've caught some massive weights of F1s, and It is a big, big difference. You know, especially at longer range as well, you know, 16 metres, that's when you, you know, 13 metres is unreal. But as we all know, it's 16.
That's the true test.
That's the true test. And I've been fishing with it at 16 against islands in that.
I notice how fast it recovers as well. That when you do strike, if you do miss a bite, instead of getting the wobble.
You wobble, it's literally just again. Immediately it's back where it was.
And again, that was the intention. And, you know, it took us a long time to get it right.
But yeah.
It's exactly what we were looking for.
Exactly, yeah.
And you're happy, and that's not easy to achieve, is it? So it must be good.
No, you know, I tell you as it is, you know, if I think something's not right and the measurements and, you know, obviously having a sample and the sample's gone back and we've changed a few things and I can't say a bad thing about it.
Big F1?
No, a little carp, that. A little common. Chunky little thing like me. Me and you, actually, Scott. Be a...
Well, it depends.
Yeah, look at that. Look where that's at, look.
Yeah, perfect. You know everything's right and working right and your beginner's balanced, don't you? Top lift every time. Some of the features that really do give it that stiffness.
Well, that's one of them, Scott. Section alignments.
Yeah, again, that's something we worked on. Just another little factor that aids to the actual overall stiffness.
Really. Yeah, you can see that's the joint. If you line them exactly right up, obviously, if you get them perfect, makes a difference in the stiffness.
Yeah, it's all part of the manufacturing process, isn't it? And by aligning them, you get the optimum performance level. And
for me personally, when I'm fishing like really long, 16 metres, that's when I line them up, because I think it makes that difference. You know, 13 metres, don't really see it that much, but it's 16 metres, if you really want that to make, you know, make sort of maximum stiffness, align them up, and makes a difference, you know, longer distances.
It's one of the things, there's many factors that have gone into making it what it is, and that's just one of them. And as you say, it's more noticeable the longer you fish.
Yeah, yeah. And just makes the perfect package at the end of the day. It's all there. If you need to do it, if you want to do it, it's there. You know, some people do, some people don't. But for me personally, like I said, long distance, 14.5, 16 metres does make a big difference.
Yeah, that combined with, as you said before, we've got the Torayca high performance carbon fibre. Yeah. All these little features, they all add up.
Yeah.
And as you say, it's just the complete package. So, with that in mind, if you want to pop the extra butts on, we'll have a look at 16 metres and hopefully we'll get a few there as well.
Just going to stick the whole lot on. So, I mean, it's so easy to ship out as well, Scott. That's 16 metres.
Yeah.
Because it's so stiff, it flows through your hands
you
better.
You really don't need to get out there, try one, and just experience it for yourself.
Yeah, it's just a doddle. I said it's virtually the same as fishing 13.
Yeah, the weight,
the
reacts,
stiffness,
the performance.
Yeah, the performance is unreal.
I think one thing worth talking about, Des, as well, is something we get asked quite a lot, is the weight of poles.
Yeah.
And I think it's worth explaining. I mean, this particular model at 13 metres, I think 790 grams, very, very light. At 14.5, it's 1,060 grams. And at the full 16 metre, a genuine full 16 metre length, you're looking at about 1,300 grams.
Yeah.
But it's all about the balance.
It's about the balance. A lot of people say to me, how heavy it is. And I say to people, look, it's not about the weight. Even though it's 13 metres, 790 grams, that is... Oh, just up one. And that, you see that then, Scott? So quick.
Absolutely.
And it's about the balance. It is about the balance of the pole and the way it feels. And that's what makes it feel light, is because it's balanced perfectly.
Yeah, I mean, realistically, you could have a lighter pole that felt heavier if the balance is incorrect, is what we're trying to say.
Yeah. You know, it's not all about that, but even so, it's 790 grams at 13. That's flipping light anyway.
Yeah. So what we've got, a really light pole at 13 metres.
Yeah.
Perfectly balanced, but most important of all, it's strong enough for this sort of fishing.
Yeah.
I mean, lots of people are doing lots of commercial fishing these days. It's got to be up to those strains.
Yeah, and I've been out with it, you know, like I said, over the last 6 months, give it a right good pasting. You know, sometimes fishing probably a little bit, pulling a bit harder than what I should do, just to see, and it's not let me down once.
And it weights up to approaching 400 pounds as well.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. About 400 pounds of fish on it, you know. some big fish, you know, getting on sort of mid doubles and stuff like that, edge fishing. And as long as you use the right top kits, like these power top kits, I mean, like I said, they're really good quality and they're, you know, they're ever so light for how strong they are. Yeah. And it's nice, really, because we've got the power tops. What you'll find with a lot of power tops is they bend. A lot of power tops bend.
They change the action.
They
the
change,
pole, yeah.
But this doesn't. The power tops on this.
You maintain the same sort
they're
of action.
They're virtually the same as what they are on your lighter tops.
But just touching on the balance and weight thing, I mean, that's worth remembering regardless of whether you're looking at a Response M90 or you're looking at any other pole, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, weight is not always crucial.
It's not.
It's nice to have a lightweight pole, but
it's the balance that's important.
Yeah, I mean, if at all possible, the best thing to do if you are investing in a pole of you know, at any price point is to try and get into a shop where you can actually see the pole and pick it up and feel it, or come to one of the shows that we do where we've got them on display.
You know, I think this year when we do the big show, I think people's eyes are going to pop out of their head, to be honest. Just the people that I've shown on the bank, they're like, hang on a minute, you know, something special here. And that's what I thought as soon as I picked it up. You know, I knew we had something, and I think people will think exactly the same.